Brave is one of the most secure and private browsers out there, but right out of the box, it comes with a bunch of bloat I'm just not a fan of. I'm talking about the built-in crypto wallet, Web3 stuff, and let's not talk about the cluttered start page. In this video, I will show you how to fix all of that. I'll walk you through exactly how I set up a fresh install of Brave. We're going to debloat it, harden it for maximum privacy, and customize it to create a super clean and efficient workflow. But before we dive in, if you find this video helpful and want to see more similar content, consider subscribing and liking the video. All right, let's dive in. First up is the initial setup. The moment you open Brave, it'll ask to be your default browser. Next, it gives you the option to import bookmarks and extensions from another browser. This is super handy if you're switching over. Then it'll ask about sending diagnostic reports. Now, this is a personal choice, but I always turn this off. Okay, let's fix that start page. It's just way too cluttered for my taste. Down in the corner, click on Customize. First, head to Brave Stats and just turn it off. Same for top sites. Now go to Cards and you can just hide everything in here. I even hide the search bar since we can just use the address bar. There we go, a simple start page. The only problem is it's a bit too simple now. It doesn't really do anything. We can fix that with one of my favorite extensions, mTab. It's an open source and incredibly customizable new tab page that looks modern and is packed with features. To save you some time, I've dropped my personal configuration for mTab in the description below. Just copy it, go into the mTab options, scroll down a little and click on Import and Save. Paste my configuration in there and click OK. Scroll down to wallpaper and choose your preferred one. Under search, you can pick your favorite search engine. I recommend Start Page. And this is where you'll add and manage your bookmarks. I won't do a deep dive into the extension itself, but trust me, it's super intuitive. This is our new tab page. You can hit the space bar to search the web, or press B to instantly search through your own bookmarks. All right, now for the fun part. Let's dive into Brave settings. Under Appearance, click on Theme and search for Midnight Black. It's a fantastic dark theme that I think looks way better than the default. Next, let's clean up that toolbar. Disable the Bookmarks button and set Show Bookmarks to Never. Don't worry, you can still access them instantly with the shortcut Control plus B. It just removes the visual clutter. I also hide the Brave News, Brave Wallet, and the sidebar buttons. Autocomplete suggestions are a personal preference, but I just turn them off completely. Make sure to enable wide address bar and show full URLs. It's just better for security. Now, under the Tabs section, enable vertical tabs, then uncheck Show Title Bar to save some screen real estate. I also like to enable expand on mouse hover. To enable this, click this collapse icon. Now, expand on hover will work like expected. The rest here can stay on default. Brave has this feature where it checks the Wayback Machine if a page is not found. It's kind of neat, but if you're not a fan, you can disable it under Content. Now, one feature I do love is Speed Reader. It gives you this beautiful, distraction-free reading mode on most websites. You can use it by clicking this little icon in the address bar. With Speed Reader, you can change the background color, the fonts, make the article wider and increase font size. It's just a fantastic experience. You can even set it to open automatically when you open an article from here. Okay, let's crank up the privacy and start hardening the browser. Head over to Shieds. Under Trackers and Ads Blocking, I set this to Aggressive. Keep in mind that this may break some websites, so if you encounter any issue, set it to Standard. Disable this option right here. Then, under Social Media Blocking, I turn all of this off. I don't need Facebook or Google following me around the web. Next, in Privacy and Security, go to Clear Browsing Data. In the On Exit tab, I check these boxes. Now, I know this might seem extreme and it can be inconvenient, but I'm just not a fan of having any browser data or cache hanging around. The only downside is that Brave doesn't let you whitelist cookies for specific sites. That's why I use an extension called Cookie Auto Delete. It lets you keep cookies for websites you trust and use daily while automatically deleting everything else when you close the browser or on domain change. Just open the extension settings, check Enable Automatic Cleaning and set a delay. I usually keep it at default here. Enable cleaning open tabs on browser startup and cleaning expired cookies. Also enable other cleanup options like cache, indexed DB, and local storage. This ensures nothing gets saved without your permission. Under extension options, make sure to uncheck the options for showing number of cookies, notifications, and the right-click context menu. To whitelist a site you're on, just click the extension icon and click on the whitelist button for all the domains you're going to see here. I like to enable send do not track me request. This may help in fingerprinting you, but I do like to enable it just to send a statement. Now, this is super important. Never, ever use Tor through Brave or any other browser besides the official Tor browser. It completely defeats the purpose of Tor's privacy protections. Make sure anything related to Tor is disabled here. Under data collection, it's simple. Disable everything. Same for Web3. I don't use any of this crypto stuff, so I just turn it all off. In the search engine settings, I disable improve search suggestions and change my search engine. My personal pick is Quant, as I find it's one of the most private and usable options I know of. Now for autofill and passwords. Please, and I can't stress this enough, never use the built-in password manager of any browser. They can be surprisingly easy for malware to steal and decode. Always use a dedicated secure password manager like KeePassXC or Bitwarden. Go into the password manager settings and just disable everything. Do the same thing for payment methods and addresses. Never save the sensitive information in your browser. Finally, let's head to system. I like to disable Brave from running in the background. I also disable the full screen reminder and make sure memory saver is on. I like to add a keyboard shortcut to toggle the vertical tabs. Inside shortcuts, search for vertical and add a shortcut for toggle vertical tabs expanded. I usually use Control plus Q. All right, for the last tip, I want to share something that I think is a total game changer that I can't live without. It helps me stay organized and private at the same time. It's using profiles. Seriously, this is the best way to separate your different online activities, and it makes it much, much harder for trackers to build a single giant profile on you. To get started with profiles, open the menu from the top right, go to More Tools and click on Add New Profile. Go ahead and give it a name, like work or shopping, whatever you plan to use it for. Now, instead of reconfiguring this new profile all over again, we're just going to copy our main one. Close Brave and open your File Explorer. Navigate to C, Users, your User folder, App Data, Local, Brave Software, Brave Browser, User Data. The default folder is our main profile that we've already configured. You'll also see a folder called Profile 1, which is the one we just created. All you have to do is open the default folder, copy everything inside it, open Profile 1 folder, delete everything, and paste the files of our default profile. Now open Brave again and select the new profile we just made. And as you can see, it's a perfect clone. It has all our settings and privacy tweaks ready to go. From here, you can customize it even further with different extensions to fit whatever you'll be doing in that profile. You can create a bunch of profiles for all your different activities. One for shopping, so those ads don't follow you everywhere. One for social media, one for work, and one for your personal browsing. It's the ultimate way to keep your digital life neat, tidy, and compartmentalized. That's it for this video. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.